launched on the 1st of July, 2023, Euclid began its journey to explore the dark universe. During the first months of commissioning, Euclid scientists initiated a sequence of thorough evaluations on the spacecraft by activating the onboard scientific instruments, testing the guidance system, monitoring telemetry, and conducting a series of diagnostic checks to ensure robust performance. During this period, scientists encountered an issue with stray light. When the solar panel faces directly towards the sun, stray light is observed. A campaign was immediately initiated to tackle this problem. Slightly rotating, Euclid reduced the stray light to a negligible level. With this issue and a problem with the reliability of the guidance system resolved, Euclid was ready to start taking science quality images. For these early release observations, we present five targets, namely the Perseus cluster of galaxies, a spiral galaxy, a regular galaxy, a globular cluster, and the Horsehead Nebula. Have you ever wondered how these images were produced? Let's embark on our journey of data processing. Euclid sends approximately 100 gigabyte of observational data each day to deep space antennas on the ground. The data is stored in a special file format used by the astronomy community called FITS, similar to an image format. While a FITS file might contain just one image frame, it can also hold multiple frames. For Euclid's visible data, it comprises 144 image frames. Each frame represents a quadrant of a Euclid visible image detector. Every four quadrants form one CCD, and Euclid's VIS camera has a total of 36 CCDs. Here's the raw image of one quadrant from one of the 16 exposures of the Perseus cluster. Upon closer inspection, you'll notice some imperfections such as cosmic rays and ghosts. Other defects such as thermal noise or optical distortion are present but are barely noticeable to the naked eye. Euclid scientists are well prepared to address these challenges. We will introduce you to a simple strategy to solve these issues. When we observe space, we take different types of pictures with our telescope. Some show the stars and galaxies we want to study, but we also take extra pictures to help us make the main ones clear. These extra pictures help us remove any little errors that come from our camera, making sure that what we see is as close as possible to what's actually out there in space. Cosmic rays detrimental to Euclid's core science need to be removed. If you compare images of the same source taken at different times, you'll see that cosmic rays don't appear in the same position twice, whereas astronomical objects remain stationary. By stacking multiple frames, cosmic rays can be identified and removed. There are also AI tools to mask out these rays. Ghosts caused by the internal reflection of a bright object captured by the CCD can be located in the image. Based on the telescope's well-understood optical structure, scientists can predict where a ghost might appear and mask it out. You might notice gaps between CCDs. To deal with this, what we do for the observation is we add a little shift between each shot we take of the sky. This shift on each pointing is referred to as dithering in astronomy. The image capture procedure is known as the reference observation sequence, or ROSE. For each pointing, the VIS instrument has an exposure time of 10 minutes, which makes it 40 minutes in total, while the NISP instrument operates simultaneously to capture slitless spectroscopy and photometry in different bands. Each ROSE will capture more than 100,000 galaxies within the Euclid field of view. This ROSE strategy is also used when Euclid surveys the sky, producing visible images and near-infrared images. As Euclid uses monochromatic detectors, images from each instrument are captured in grayscale. To transform them into a color image, we need to map the images coming from each instrument with a respective color. This mapping is what you see here. In the future, Euclid will survey 1/3 of the sky. You can reveal all of them at this scale level. Euclid is currently undergoing its final testing in full science mode. Soon, it will commence its nominal survey and delve into the mysteries of the dark universe.